Howdy everybody, welcome to another adventure in Drew's Hobbies and Fun. Today I'm working on one of my hobbies. It's backyard maple syrup production, and I'm working on building myself a file cabinet evaporator. Used to be a four drawer cabinet, nice and deep. I'm modeling it after actual production evaporators. I'm going to cut it out on the red line, all the way around the other side, underneath. And then I'm going to flip that over and weld it back in. It'll come in right along here. And that'll give me my heat channel underneath the pan. And then up here, I'll have my firebox. Right here is my grate, just happens to fit the width perfectly. It's gonna go in on this end. I'm gonna build a door right here using one of the file cabinet doors over there. And then I'll have a clean out door there / forced air induction. And then for now, because I have a short pan, I'll be bringing my pipe out right here. Eventually, when I get a custom pan built to fit this specifically, I'm gonna bring it out right here. All right, we'll talk to you again when I'm a little farther along. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back with a little update. What you're looking at here is gonna be the top of the pan. Where the pan sits. Door is gonna be right there. Here you can see I've got the fireplace or the area set up. This is gonna be our heat channel going under the pan with the flue coming out right here. Walk around it so you can see what's up. What I did with the rest of it, piece I cut off, I just flipped it over. I'm gonna weld it back up all the way around, and then I'll seal it with high heat caulk, silicone, like fireplace stuff. And then I'll trim this up, make it look decent when I'm done, and put some legs on it. I'll be back. All right, folks, we're back. Here's my progress. We got everything stitch welded. I think it's gonna work pretty darn slick. And this is my daughter, she's a dork. She's helping, she helps make syrup. All right, time for legs and a door. We'll be back.
Did you just pause it?
All right, folks, welcome back. A little more progress on my evaporator. Don't mind my messy garage. I added some legs and runners onto the bottom so I can move it around. Pretty much the same on that side. And I got some stove sealer. Sealed up all my gas because I know they leak. They're in bad shape. I've only got a flux welder. And then I've got some hand-me-down firebricks from an old grocery store oven. And my big cast iron grate I got from my neighbor. Not sure where he got it from, but it fits this perfectly. Now I'm just waiting on hinges. I can put my doors on, my draft door and my fire door. This is what I'm gonna use for my door. Just the front of the filing cabinet. I just cut it off. The rest of the drawer, tacked everything together. And it's already got a handle on it. And I'm just gonna use this piece of tin to, if I can close the trap door. We've also got that flat rope for a wood stove. I think I got 10 feet of it. I'm gonna use to seal the pan and the doors. All right, I'll be back when I got more progress. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back. Our finished product here. All ready to put the first fire up. Here's my finished door. I used a file cabinet door, some cheap hinges. Here's my draft door, just a piece of sheet metal from a section I cut off. Just some random hardware I found in the garage. A bolt, nut and bolt. A little bit of firebrick. I didn't take the time to get it perfect because this is my quick and dirty build. Here's my pan and pre-warmer that I'm going to use until I order the correct one. I'm gonna make it go all the way to here. My stack's gonna come out the back. I'll open up the top now to show you what the inside looks like. There's my pre-warmer and my drip valve. This is an Amish-made pan, in case anyone is wondering. Little scorched from a bad mistake last year. A little firebrick up in there. That's just a piece of cut off sheet metal I screwed down to take up space for now. Pieces of scrap metal here I used to hold the brick in. There's my sealer again. Alright, that's it. Oh, I've got to support my chimney better. I just have it wired for now. It's not really working. But I'll fix that before I run the first time. Alright, I'll have one more clip when I have it running. Alright, here we go. Looks like it's doing pretty good. I don't have flames shooting out anywhere. Shouldn't be. Everything's all nice and heated up. I don't have a boil yet, because I discovered that the ball on my float was bent up too far. Somehow it got banged around during storage, and it overfilled my pan. But overall, this evaporator was a success. I do have to get some more insulation under here. You can see a gap on the front for some reason. So I'm gonna go to the supplier for syrup supplies and just insulate that a little better, fix my chimney, fix my float, and I'll be in awesome shape for the year. All right, thank you all for watching. Leave a thumbs up or some comments if you like, and I'll see you on my next video.